road crash leaves 7 dead in Mymensingh. Pollution put existence of country's river at stake. Do not make supply chain hostage, warns State Minister for Commerce. Imprisoned Russian opposition leader Navalny dies. Those were the headlines. You're watching ATN News. Good evening, viewers. I'm Rubaba Ahmed with English Bulletin. Seven people, including three of a family, were killed when a bus collided with a CNG auto rickshaw in Mymensingh on Friday. The mishap occurred at around 11 a.m. in Alalpur area of Shadar Upazila. Officer in charge of Kotwali Model Police Station, Anwar Hussain, said a Sherpur-bound bus of Adil Transport Company from Dhaka collided with a CNG auto rickshaw coming from the opposite direction after it reached Alalpur. Seven people, including the CNG auto rickshaw driver, died on the spot. The victims were identified as Babul Ahmed from Rambhadrapur of Fulpur Upazila, his wife Shilakhtar, son Mohammad Sadman, and CNG auto rickshaw driver Alamin Hussain. He hails from Dio village of Fulpur Upazila. Identities of other three victims could not be ascertained. Police have seized the bus. The driver and helper of the bus are at large. Rivers are considered as the lifeline of the riverine Bangladesh. However, grabbing of lands by land sharks and dumping of industrial waste have put the existence of most of the rivers at stake. Known as the Dandy of the East, Narayanganj was built around Shitalakha River. However, severe pollution has made its water unusable. Big ships are no more sailing through the river as its navigability has lessened. They saw subsequent closure of the export. Two banks of the river have gone under encroachment. Munshiganj is surrounded by Dholeshwari, Meghna, Podda and Isamati River. The water of Dholeshwari is now facing severe pollution due to dumping of waste from the cement factory and other different factories. Once known as the blessing for the people of Mymensingh and Ghazipur, Khiru River has now turned alarmingly poisonous due to dumping of industrial waste. Vigilance is on so that none could make the supply chain hostage. State Minister for Commerce Ahsanul Islam Titu made the remark at a views exchange at his residence in Dildaur of Tangail. He said the number of ship owners, millers and wholesalers are very scanty. It will have to be seen so that these people cannot make supply chain hostage through stockpiling. The government is trying level best to ensure that all wholesalers get the commodities to keep the supply linked uninterrupted, the state minister added. Government has no hand over the case filed against Dr. Mohammad Yunus. Minister for Law, Justice and Parliamentary Affairs Anisul Haque made the remark while talking to the media at Akhaura Railway Station on Friday. He was replying a question over the concern of United Nations to the trial of Dr. Yunus. Law Minister said National Board of Revenue and Sovereign Organization, the Anti-Corruption Commission, has filed the cases against Dr. Yunus. So the government has no connection with these cases. Today marks the 82nd birth anniversary of renowned nuclear scientist and Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina's late husband, Dr. Wajid Mia. Rongpur District Chapter, Awami League, Chhatra League, and different political and socio-cultural organizations offered Fatiha at the grave of Dr. Wajid Mia and paid homage by placing reeds at Fatehpur in Pirganj of Rongpur, marking the day. Several distinguished personalities, including the Vice Chancellor of Begum Rokeya University, Dr. Hasibur Rashid, were present at the time. Other events of the day included distributing food among the destitute people. Dr. Wajid Mia was born on February 16th in 1942. He passed away in Dhaka on May 9th in 2009. Jailed Russian opposition politician Alexei Navalny has died. The prison service of the Yamalo-Nenets region, where he had been serving his sentence, has said. Navalny, an outspoken critic of Russian President Vladimir Putin, has been in Russia jail since 2021 on charges that are widely viewed as politically motivated. Kira Yarmashi, Navalny's spokesperson, said, his team has yet to receive confirmation of the death, but his lawyer was now traveling to Siberia. Kremlin spokesperson Dmitry Peskov said Russia's penitentiary service was making all checks regarding Navalny's death, but had no information about the matter. In August, Navalny was found guilty of founding and funding an extremist organization, which he denies, and was given an extra 19 years to his existing sentence. He had already been sentenced to 9 years for parole violations, fraud and contempt of court. Now a short break. We will be back soon with Imran picks Omar Ayub as Prime Minister nominee. You're watching ATN News. This is English Bulletin. It is expected that Upazila polls will be held smoothly and peacefully, as there is no party symbol in the polls. However, there is an apprehension of clashes in the polls. Minister for Local Government, Rural Development and Cooperative Tajul Islam made the remark while addressing a debate competition in the capital on Friday. The debate competition was organized by Debate for Democracy. Addressing the same event, Chairman of Debate for Democracy, Hassan Ahmed Chaudhry Kiran, said threshold people will get more service if the structure of the local government is made more accountable. News around the world. Jailed Pakistan cricket legend turned politician Imran Khan has named a man in hiding as his pick for Pakistan's prime minister. Omar Ayub Khan will run against the candidate of Imran Khan's rivals. Ayub, one of the former prime minister's party leaders, is currently wanted by police on criminal charges that does not bar him from running. However, despite Khan's independent unexpectedly winning the most seats in last week's election, they do not have enough to form a government. Currently, the two main rivals appear on course to take control. After they formed a coalition, Nawaz Sharif's Pakistan Muslim League, PMLN, and Bilawal Bhutto Zardari Pakistan People's Party, PPP, a senior leader of Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf PTI party, Asad Kaiser, announced Ayub as his pick for PM after meeting with the former premier in prison. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has rejected U.S. President Biden's call to protect civilians living in Rafah city of Gaza. Biden made the request in a telephone conversation with Netanyahu on telephone on Thursday night. In the 40 minutes long conversation, Biden told Netanyahu it will be a wrong step to go for military offensive in southern Gaza without ensuring safety of the 10 lakh people living there. That will be catastrophic. In reply, Netanyahu said Israel will not let anyone dictating them and will continue to oppose the unilateral recognition of a Palestinian state. It would be a huge reward to unprecedented terrorism. Meanwhile, Israeli forces stormed Nasser Hospital in Khan Yunis after weeks of besieging the medical centers. Local authorities called another war crime against Palestinians. Israel's attack on Gaza have killed at least 28,663 Palestinians since war with Hamas broke out on October 7th. At least 11 people have died in a fire that broke out in a market area in Delhi's Alipur on Thursday evening. It erupted at a paint factory and engulfed two godowns and a de-addiction center. Friday officials said the burned bodies of the 11 victims were found in the factory in Alipur's Dayalpur market. Officials said four people injured in the fire, including a cop, are undergoing treatment and two others are feared trapped. The fire department, which was informed about the incident at 5:25 p.m. Thursday, rushed six fire engines to the spot and brought the fire under control within 4 hours, an official said. The fire got spread to an adjacent house and a Nasha Mukti Kendro. There will be a blast due to which the building collapsed, trapping the 11 laborers who lost their lives. Director of Fire Service said the bodies are badly burnt, making them difficult to identify. Before ending the bulletin, the top stories once again. Road crash leaves 7 dead in Mymensingh. Pollution put existence of country's river at stake. Do not make supply chain hostage, warns State Minister for Commerce. Imprisoned Russian opposition leader Navalny dies. Imran picks Omar Ayub as Prime Minister nominee. That's all from Newsroom for the moment. Thank you for being with us.